Hi friends, welcome back to Striving Aspirants. In this video presentation, we are checking some examples related to activity or turnover ratios. In the last presentation, I have already given some introductory part related to these ratios. Those who need can check the link in the description here. So let us check each examples one by one. We have already seen the activity or turnover ratios, which include stock or inventory turnover ratio, debtors or receivable turnover ratio, creditors or payable turnover ratio, investment or net assets turnover, which constitute fixed asset turnover ratio and working capital turnover ratio. First, we can check the example related to stock or inventory turnover ratio. We have these given information here. Opening stock 18,000, wages 14,000, closing stock 22,000, sales 80,000, purchases 46,000, carriage or freight inwards 4,000. We know the stock turnover ratio formula is cost of goods sold or sales divided by average stock or inventory. Cost of goods sold can be also calculated as opening stock plus purchases plus direct expense minus closing stock. Here we have this information: opening stock 18,000 plus purchases 46,000 plus direct expense, which include wages 14,000 and the carriage inwards 4,000. We have to add all these information, then we have to deduct the closing stock amount, which is 22,000. So we will get the cost of goods sold amount 60,000. Secondly, we have to calculate the average stock. The formula is opening stock plus closing stock divided by 2. We have the given information: opening stock here 18,000 plus closing stock 22,000 divided by 2. So the average stock amount is 20,000. Now we got the stock turnover ratio, which will be 60,000, that is the cost of goods sold, divided by 20,000, that is the average stock. And we get the answer as stock turnover ratio equal to 3 times. Now let us check another example related to stock or inventory turnover ratio. We have this given information here: sales 4 lakh, average stock 55,000, gross loss ratio is 10%. We have to calculate cost of goods sold. The formula we have to apply here is sales plus gross loss. Here we have to note that the cost of goods sold means sales less gross profit. But here the information given is gross loss ratio. So in that case, we have to add gross loss plus sales amount. Now we will take the amounts: sales 4 lakh plus gross loss 40,000, which means 10% of sales amount, that is 4 lakh. We got 40,000, so we will add these both amount, we will get 4,40,000, which is the cost of goods sold amount. Now we can directly apply the formula stock turnover ratio equal to cost of goods sold, which we got 4,40,000, and the average stock we have already here 55,000. Now the turnover we will get is 8 times. Next one is debtors turnover ratio. We will check one example here. Let us check the information given: total sales 4 lakh, cash sales 20% of total sales, debtors on 1/1/2019 40,000, and debtors on 31st December 2019 is 120,000. First one, we will take the average debtors, which is opening debtors plus closing debtors divided by 2. Here we have the amount 40,000 plus 120,000 divided by 2. We get the amount average debtors as 80,000. Now we will calculate the net credit sales amount, which will be equal to total sales minus cash sales. We have the total sales here 4 lakh minus cash sales is 20% of total sales. 20% of 4 lakh, which will give 80,000. So net credit sales will be 4 lakh minus 80,000, which will give 3,20,000. That is the net credit sales amount, which will be the 80% of total sales. Now we will apply the formula. Debtors turnover ratio equal to net credit sales amount, which is 3,20,000 we have got here, divided by average debtors, which is 80,000. Now the turnover ratio will be 4 times. Let us check the example related to creditors or payable turnover ratio. We have this given information here. Credit purchase during 2019, 12 lakh. Then creditors plus bills payable on 1/1/2019, which is 4 lakh, plus this one, creditors plus bills payable on 31st December 2019, which is 2 lakh here. First we will check the average creditors amount. Average creditors amount will be 4 lakh plus 2 lakh divided by 2. That is opening creditors plus bills payable amount and the closing creditors plus bills payable amount divided by 2, which will give 3 lakh. That is the average creditors value. And the net credit purchase, which is already given in the problem, which is 12 lakh. Now we will apply the formula. Creditors turnover ratio equal to net credit purchase divided by average accounts payable, which will give 12 lakh divided by 3 lakh, and the turnover ratio is 4 times. Finally, we will check the investment or net assets turnover ratio example. Investment or net assets turnover ratio, which constitute two ratios, which is fixed asset turnover and working capital turnover. Investment or capital turnover ratio equal to net sales divided by capital employed. Fixed asset turnover equal to net sales divided by net fixed assets value. And working capital turnover equal to net sales divided by working capital. Now we will check the balance sheet extract given here. We have this good information in the liability side of balance sheet. Preference share capital 4 lakh, equity share capital 6 lakh, the general reserve 1 lakh, profit and loss account 3 lakh, 15% debentures 2 lakh, 14% loan 2 lakh, creditors 1,40,000, bills payable 50,000, and outstanding expense 10,000. Similarly, in the asset side of balance sheet extract here, plant and machinery 8 lakh, land and building 5 lakh, motor van 2 lakh, furniture 1 lakh, stock 1,80,000, debtors 1,10,000, bank 80,000, cash 30,000. Also, the sales value given here is 30 lakh. First one, we will check the capital employed, which is equal to share capital plus reserves and surplus plus long term debt or net assets, which is 4 lakh plus 6 lakh. that is the preference share capital and equity share capital, plus the reserves and surplus value, which include general reserve 1 lakh and the profit and loss account value, that is 3 lakh, plus long term debt, which constitute 15% debenture, that is 2 lakh, and the 14% loan amount, which is 2 lakh. Total of all these will give the capital employed value, which is 18 lakh. Now we will calculate the fixed assets value, which include plant and machinery 8 lakh plus, land and building 5 lakh plus, motor van 2 lakh plus, furniture value which is 1 lakh. So the fixed assets total is 16 lakh. Now we will check the working capital, which is equal to current asset minus current liabilities. Current assets we will take stock, debtors, bank and cash, which will give the total 4 lakh, minus current liabilities we will take the creditors, bills payable and the outstanding expense. The amount we will get is 2 lakh. Now the working capital value is 2 lakh. Now we have got the necessary values to calculate the three ratios here. First one is net assets turnover ratio, or the investment turnover ratio, or the capital turnover ratio, which we have to calculate. Formula is net sales divided by capital employed. The value will be 30 lakh divided by 18 lakh, which will give 1.67 times, that is the net assets or capital or investment turnover ratio value. Similarly, we will apply the other formulas here. Fixed asset turnover equal to net sales divided by net fixed asset. The values will be 30 lakh divided by 16 lakh, which is the fixed asset turnover ratio equal to 1.88 times, that is the fixed asset turnover. Finally, working capital turnover. The formula is net sales divided by working capital. Net sales value we have here 30 lakh divided by working capital value, which is 2 lakh. Now we have the working capital turnover, that is 15 times. So that's all about the activity or turnover ratios examples. I believe that you guys got idea regarding all these examples given here. It is not that much as given in this slide. We have to be very much aware of all these formulas. We have to by heart all these formulas, and we have to calculate each one, try more examples, so we'll be in a better position to do more examples related to activity or turnover ratio. Okay friends, now we will see in another video. Until then, it is bye from Striving Aspirants. Take care. Thank you for watching this video also. Subscribe our channel and support us. Bye bye.